كان أغني فاير غادي غادي واي فاير يس بس بس بين جاكس دي من وسوري سو غادي غادي فاير I'm gonna do that females too. I'm gonna do it to my fire guys. And I think I'll make her be. Let's see, I think I'll make her be. I'll go with here we go, show stuff, I'll go with that one. Name for her, so we're gonna go with alright, okay, Kaylee Jackson, who's the daughter of Samantha Jackson, so and Jackson went over 50, so we're going to dip in over her daughter, so we're going to 41. Make a third visa. And she's a bit can hit it for her, and it can go with same hair color as well, so with equipment, so we got a little necklace for her. Let's go to the vet. Let's do the vet too. To the phone for his Wednesdays to see him in the week. Just amazing, let's see. And I got the music and everything set up. I'm gonna start the career.
Welcome back to MLB Tonight.
You know, do the skills and stuff and then.
Welcome to day one of the Sour BP started now, and that's where the scouts really, really bear down.
Okay, we got to back him up. Probably really good. Just like him up. I did the dig. He's saying he's going to turn and
come in. Swing, and they're looking at the ability if they can hit the ball the entire field.
And there's so much data that comes along with BP. We've got exit velocity, which means we can look at how often the player's hitting the ball hard. In this day and age, hitting the ball hard has an actual definition. That's 95 miles an hour. And why do we care about that? Because in today's game, if you hit the ball hard, you're going to hit about 500 on those batting balls with a 1,000 slugging percent.
Another stat
we'll look at is launch angle, and what we define as a sweet spot batting ball is 8 to 32 degrees of launch angle, basically a line drive. So I'll be looking at how often these players will be making that kind of contact as well.
You know, I think about big league players like Alvarez, Judge, Otani, Trout. Their hard hit ball data is crazy. Their launch angles are very, very, very consistent. And you add all the things that we're evaluating and think about, Sarah, the pressure these young players are under right now is probably the most pressure-packed BP these players have ever taken in their careers.
All right, here we go. To the shortstop.
Sarah, we're in the infield play now. I have to tell you, this is my favorite part of the combine. From a scouting perspective, every time I walked into the ballpark, I'd always focus on my shortstops to begin with. I'd look at their footwork. I'd look at their body control. I look at their glove-to-hand transfer and how accurate their arms were. You know, we are an industry that loves arm strength, but it's the quickness of the ball out of the glove, and it's the accuracy of the throw that's important. And I'm trying to see which of these players really check those boxes off for me.
Well, that exchange is something we can now measure thanks to StatCast, which is outstanding. In terms of metrics, obviously, we are going to focus on that arm strength, even though I agree it isn't the end-all be-all, and your shortstops are certainly the ones leading the way. Average of about 86.3 miles an hour on that max effort arm strength in 2023. Again, that's their top 10% of their throw. The absolute best of the best. And that doesn't even account for the guys like Ellie Dilly Cruz out here.
And, you know, it's really interesting, Sarah, if you watch the drill work that's being done. So they started balls at them, then they went the glove side, then they went to the open backhand side to really see what arm strength was. And then they finish with slow rollers, both the backhand slow roller and the ball they came in at, trying to see how they utilize their body and if they can throw from different arm angles. Let's take a look at the third base position. You know, when I think of third base, I think of Nolan Arenado. So I'm looking at first step quickness and body control and if they can throw from different angles. So in this drill, let's focus on that. When we turn to second base, look at angle reads. The best second basemen in the game, they've got great first step quickness and they've got great angle reads to the ball.
Okay, well.
Down to the pitchers now, Sarah.
All right, the next level,
they look at pitcher. They're looking at, you know, how well their body works over the rubber. I talk about balance, rhythm, and timing within their delivery. You're certainly looking at arm strength. They're going to measure spin, horizontal movement. But you really got to look at command. I mean, where the catcher's set up, can you throw the ball to that spot, you know, within the strike zone or outside the strike zone, and can you do that with multiple pitches?
As you said, are the handful of things that will be measured here, of course, the
Let's see
velocity.
here again.
You mentioned spin rate. Something else clubs take a look at is active spin. That's what percentage of that spin rate actually
Let's see,
contributes
right, that's
to
how
your movement, as
you.
opposed
Right,
to
that's
just
how you.
spinning but not changing the way the ball is actually moving.
And so that's why deliveries are so important. Every one of those metrics, Sarah, is tied to your ability to duplicate your unique body type.
And
that's
target.
Why you can get a lot out of these bullpen sessions by bearing down on a pitcher's delivery. Wow, that's as impressive a bullpen session as you're going to see. She commanded all quadrants of the strike zone, showed well above average arm strength, a tremendous feel to spin a breaking ball, great balance, rhythm, and timing over the rubber, great extension out front. Honestly, that's what a number one starter's bullpen would look like.
The Angels, the Rockies, the White Sox, the Cleveland, the Pirates, and the Washington Nationals. This is a very good zoom. Oh, this is in Caitlin. So guys, I'm gonna end the video right here. Thank you guys for watching. If you comment, subscribe, and you see the video on the 7/24 location number. I tell you another part of MLB The Show 24. Welcome to the show. The journey of Kayla Jackson, the daughter of Samantha Jackson. And yeah, and then the next part we're gonna do the combat games in part 2. So yeah, so all my comments, subscribers, thank you for coming on the video. To all my new subscribers, thank you for joining the rest of your fame. I'll see you all in the next part of MLB The Show. MLB The Show 24, welcome to the show. The journey of Samantha, the journey of Kayla Jackson, the daughter of Samantha Jackson. Jackson, bye for now.